Hi all, electrical engineer Igor Ekimov is with you again. At the request of viewers, I will tell you how to correctly install and connect a simple floor heating thermostat RTC-70. The total share of such thermostats among those installed by me is about 70%. Therefore, I decided to review it in a separate video. The place for installing the thermostat is prepared during the rough renovation, when the electric heated floor is installed. I will look at laying infrared heated floors and warm mats in the following videos. Subscribe to the channel and press the bell so you don't miss these videos. I will also be grateful for your likes and reposts. They are valuable to me. A properly prepared place is a socket box, cleared of plaster, putty and wallpaper. The socket box has two holes for attaching the thermostat. The distance between them is 6 centimeters. The socket box must be spacious enough to accommodate the thermostat housing and all suitable wires. The following must be inserted into the socket box: warm floor sensor wire in a corrugation. The corrugation must be protected from plaster and putty getting into it. We will look at how to properly insert this wire into the corrugation in a video on laying heated floors. A 220-volt supply cable is also suitable, and the cable fits to the heated floor. Moreover, it is necessary to check the integrity of the heated floor both after laying the heated floor and before installing the thermostat using a multimeter. To do this, measure its resistance. Usually, it is indicated in the instructions for the heated floor, and ranges from several tens to several hundred ohms. We turn off the voltage using a circuit breaker in the switchboard. We make sure that there is no phase using a proven indicator screwdriver. We shorten the supply cables to 10 centimeters. Cut them, and clean the wires themselves. I have everything ready for installation. We take the thermostat and connect the temperature sensor. This is how the temperature sensor is indicated on the thermostat. There is no need to observe polarity. Unscrew it. We insert it. We twist it. Next, we connect the heated floor itself. First and second conclusion. We insert it. We do not connect the grounding wire yet. We take him aside. Next, we connect the power to the thermostat. Let's see. Here the phase is indicated, and here is zero. They cannot be confused, since the thermostat only interrupts the phase. If we mix it up, then the phase will be constantly supplied to the warm floor, even if the thermostat is turned off. As you can see, all wires are connected to the thermostat. Only the ground wires remain. We connect them using a terminal block. Here we connected the grounding wires using a terminal block. Since this is a ground wire, it would be better to twist them and solder them. It also happens that underfloor heating has a grounding braid instead of a yellow-green wire. It needs to be twisted and insulated using thermo cambric. Then we also connect the grounding wires with a terminal block or solder them together. In general, all regulators are connected in a similar way. Only the location of the pins to which the wires are connected and the terminals themselves to which they are connected differ. Turn it over. We set the temperature on the thermostat to 40 degrees. We have to position the wheel in this position when we assemble the thermostat. We turn on the machine in the control panel, turn on the thermostat, and we see that the regulator is connected. And its LED is on because it is in heating mode. I have a light bulb connected instead of a warm floor, and you see that it caught fire. We can adjust the regulator. You see, he turned off. Return it to the 40-degree position. Turn off the thermostat and turn off the machine in the control panel. Remove the wheel to adjust the temperature. This can be done either with a flat screwdriver, or it can be done the way I do it, prying it with a fingernail. Unscrew the screw under the wheel. The front panel and frame are easily removed. Moreover, this outer frame can be removed and only one frame can be used. It all depends on what kind of thermostat design you like. More square or with rounded edges. I also want to point out a common mistake. This regulator is often called mechanical. This is not true. This is an electronic regulator, but not programmable. The floor control is done electronically. Mechanical thermostats do not contain electronics. There it is usually controlled by a thermocouple, as is done in irons. We lay the wires in the socket box. Install them. Insert the screws, and now tighten them. Before tightening the screws, check the level. Now we clamp. Let's check the level again. Now we assemble the thermostat. We put a frame. Place the cover panel. And screw it on. We know that our wheel was at 40 degrees. We direct it to 40 degrees and install it. We turn on the power using the machine in the panel. Turn on the thermostat. Since our temperature is 40 degrees, our thermostat turns on the floor heating. And our light bulb turns on instead of the heated floor. We can reduce the temperature to, say, 20 degrees. Since the sensor temperature is higher, the thermostat turned off the heating of the heated floor. In order for the thermostat to turn on the heated floor again, you need to set the thermostat to a higher temperature. We set the floor heating to 33 degrees. And the thermostat turned on the heated floor for heating. We checked that the thermostat is working. Next we check the heated floor for heating. We turn on the thermostat to maximum heat and wait for the floor to heat up. Typically, for a warm mat, the heating effect is felt after half an hour. And for an infrared floor after a few minutes. This is where I end the video. If you have any questions, write them in the comments. You can also tell us about your experience installing these thermostats. Subscribe to the channel and press the bell so you don't miss new videos. Share the video with those who might be interested. See you in new and old videos.